Dobar dan, dobrodošli. Ja sam Linda Msimbi Libese iz Kenije. Živim ovdje a little bit over 8 years. And we are doing a podcast for CMS on integration. So today we are going to talk about our lives in Croatia. Thank you. Can you please introduce yourselves?
My name is Mirsad. Zovem se Mirsad. Dalipi, dolazim sa Kosova i živim u Zagrebu već isto 8 godina skoro.
Super.
My name is Prince Walešoniki. Ja sam iz Nigerije. Ovdje živim, majke mi, skoro 10 godina. I eto, još nisam Hrvati, ali mislim da sam blizu, skoro.
Super. So, when did you actually come to Croatia and how did it feel?
Prije 8 godina i naravno razlog zašto sam došao tu je moja buduća današnja žena, supruga. I zapravo da, kako sam se osjećao, pa nismo znali šta nas očekiva, šta će biti, kako će to izgledat, ali očigledno to očekivanje su se menjali sa vremenom i sad je postao lakše sa dosta nelagodnim situacijama, ali sve u svemu je dobro.
Super. Prince?
Okay.
When did you come and how did you feel?
Znaš, sada pričam ko neki odavde puge, kaj. Došao sam prije 10 godina, 2011, baš kraj 2011, mogu seća 25. dezembra, to je on Božić, Xmas. Nekako osjećam da ovdje mogu živjeti, ovdje je mirno, sigurno je zemlje i odmah sam skužio da mogu nešto napraviti drugačije ako ostajem tu. Tako da, tako sam ostaje, nije mi lako, kako si to rekao, između sve do sada, ali sada ok, hvala Bogu. Evo,
I felt čudno. It was interesting. I was like, where am I? Am I in the right place? Should I go back? But like we say, we survive and get along and get adjusted. So is there anything in particular that you like about Croatia or the least you don't like?
A vjerovatno bi se mi složili najviše o tome da ta papirologija je nešto u kome nikako ne mogu s time ponositi. A to je kad idu, ne znam, izvaditi dokumente, ono ti šalteri gdje su kao za stranci gdje moraš čekati 4-5 sati. I to je jedini stvar koji stvarno ja mislim da to ne zaslužimo. Ono. Sve ovo ostalo drugo možemo preživjeti, ali daj više nam, ono, barem ako idemo tim državnim institucijama gdje kao ono pozivaju kao na jednakost sve to, ali kad ideš tamo definitivno, sigurno sam da ste to prošli i prošli ste dan danas, tu se ne osjećate baš najbolje i onda tu ponekad kažem joj, ono, u moju zemlju, ono, idem tamo, znam sve i sve ima, joj, dobar dan, oj, gdje si mi sad dođi, šta ti treba ovo, ide ta papir, ide van, a tu stvarno baš time nam ganjao jako puno. Taj dio mi nije dobro.
Super. Prince, is there, can you like think of just something specifically you like and something specifically you don't like?
Well, na tom pitanju, for me, when I came, I didn't think about, like, I want to come here to work or study or something. I'm just looking for somewhere to lay rest, lay low, dane niko nečio mene I sve. Then it comes, like, integration. Can you live among people? Would they accept you? I was living in Kutina. It's like hell in Rye. Coincidentally, now my girlfriend or my Lubavi mother of my child, she's from Kutina. Cannot believe it.
Cannot go far away.
Yes.
Destiny.
I think my answer covers everything.
Have you guys ever been misunderstood due to language barrier? I know for myself in the beginning, because of not speaking Croatian and fumbling with Google Translation, I ended up in the wrong tram, wrong bus, and I arrived my destination literally 5 hours later, out getting lost several times. So have you guys been in that situation at one point, whether at home with your spouses or a cafe, any situation?
A lot. So I do that. I go to a coffee shop. I sit down, Bog, Dabadan. Kakosi. I look my paper. Dobro Sam. Otakli City. Yes, I'm is Nigeria. Ah, super. Strajelish Piti. That's, I know I'm going to coffee shop now. They will ask me, Jelim Piti, Shai Ot Shupak. And this girl say, morning. I said, what is morning?
Was she shocked record. Or she felt offended?
For me,
you didn't know.
For me, I think I'm speaking perfect Croatian because it was written. And she said, morning, just the record. I said, Jelim Kupiti Shai Ut Shupak.
It's good. Shupak. And with the.
She said, check out. She went to call the boss, and the boss called, hey, what is Jelish? Jelim Kupiti Chai.
Shupak.
Oh, Shupak. And he saw my paper and said, oh, Budara. Hey, Shupak. Shupak.
Yeah, I learned the hard way
about
that.
It's on TV.
Mirsad, would you like to share anything shortly about any misunderstandings in
Croatia? Pa da, ima tu puno toga. Svaki dan, dan danas se to dešava. Mislim, i kad pričam sa, i sa svojim prijateljima i sa svojim suprugom, zna se desiti ono kao pričamo možda iste stvari, samo koristimo par riječi drugačije koje ja možda ne koristim u mojoj vokabulari, onda to zna često biti ono, pa kako to nisi napravio, to si rekao da ćeš to raditi, ti ovako i sad, pa ne, ja sam to radio, ja sam to, ja sam ovako. I na kraju, ne znam, nakon 10 minuta to neke rasprave, onda skužimo da zapravo smo iste stvari pričali, samo nismo se razumeli. Ne,
u tom slučaju, doma, sada sa moja partner, uvijek kad ona mi reci, a princ, donesi mi ovo, donesi mi ono, ja mislim da razumijem Hrvatska, ali mislim da ništa ne razumijem više. Uvijek ona živte na kraju, jesi ti čujem, jesi ti meni razumi? Tako, razumijem te, ali...
Ali šta hoćeš da donesem?
Teško je, šta da donesem? Još nešto oko hrvatski jezik. Kad si u Zagreb, drugačije. Kad si na moru, ili kad si... Sve drugačije. Na brod, radio sam na brod 2 godine. Ekipa mi pita kad sam došao, jesi ti zna hrvatski? Ja kao, brate, ja pričam ko da sam ovdje rođen. Kaj ovdje? Donesi mi sugar man. Ja brzo otići po šuge, šećer. Evo ti šećer. Kaj, sugar man. Pa šećer. Kaže, ne. Sugar man je towel. Ručnik. Kako to sugar man ručnik?
Vidiš.
To je, znači, hrvatski jezik. Čovjek mora putio okolo hrvatske da bi može razumjeti.
Like all of us, we have enough stories, but I just remembered one of my favorite ones of misunderstanding was I was teaching myself Croatian in the beginning on the internet, and I learned a DA is called Jelena. And my husband will say a yell, like when you say something like yell. Or yell, yes. And then in my mind, I was always thinking he's abusing me. And one time I just exploded. Why are you always calling me an animal? And it's like, what do you mean? Yes, you're always calling me yell, and I know that's an animal. And he was like, what do you mean? And I went and, you see? He's like, Jelena. Oh, and it was very funny. And up today, we still laugh about it because in my mind, I thought he's literally calling me an animal. You
animal,
know?
Jelen. Yeah. But it's, ali zna, to je zna biti često i na priču kao, jeli.
Yes, jeli. Because everything in my mind was like, yell.
Da, šta god priča, da.
In English, is that so, yell?
Nisam siguran.
Is that so?
Okay, so do you guys feel like Croatians yet? Are you Croatians yet?
With myself, I feel Croatian, but I think with society, I don't feel still Croatian. Because, okay, one of the reasons also maybe because we are not born here, mi smo rođeni tu i ne možu imati taj isti osjećaj kako je osjećaj od nekog ko je rođen ovdje, ali u mojom osobnim osjećama, kako već tu živim, kako sam uključen u društvo, osjećam da pripadam tu, ali isto vrijeme, kad, znaš šta, ja mislim da svaki od nas ima to, kad je nešto najteško, kad je nešto ono gdje se osjećaš usamljen, onda tu vidiš da kao nisi iz ovog mjesta ili iz ovog područja i onda odmah misliš kao jel, kad bi bio možda doma, tamo bi bio malo drugačije, da. Lakše. Posebno kad ostanem bez posla, kad nemamo, ne znam, prihode i sve to, onda to postane malo kao ta neka nostalgija, da sam doma, a to vjerovatno ima veze s time kako smo odgajani doma, ne uvijek u našu moju kulturu kao doma neko radi, pa ovi drugi ostali jede i uživaju, mislim, uživaju tako. A ovdje kad si onda samostalan sve i radiš sve to sam, onda puno je to teže i onda u tom situaciji mogu bi povezati da ponekad mi fali, kao kako nisam doma, tamo bi mogu imat sve, ali samo vrtiš se natrag i kažeš, ne, zapravo ja sam doma, tu sam ja. A sad, da li tu ima stvari koje mi se ne sviđa ili ne pripadam, to ja ne mogu odlučiti, to odluči drugi društvo. Društvo bi treba gledati to da ja sam Hrvata, ne da mi stavi kao on je od nekuda je došao.
Well, kako mi sad rekao, it's sometimes it's a very sad issue.
I understand. I have a personal saying, you always say once a foreigner, always a foreigner.
Do you feel Croatian?
Yeah, as much as you feel at home, there will always be a moment or something that will remind you you're a foreigner again.
I've done a lot in Croatia, in Zagreb. I own the restaurant. I meet thousands of people. I sometimes I forget that I'm black, not a foreigner.
Da, ja, okay, isto stvar. Da,
all
da,
my
da,
friends,
da.
They are Croatians. You know, when we meet, I thought I'm Croatian because I speak Croatian. I sleep in Croatian house. I live here.
Yeah,
my life. I don't. Things until someone say, hey, Afrikaner,
or can I touch your hair?
Or we talk about Africa and everything. And the system don't make you a Croatian. The system make you African, a black man, a stranger, a foreigner.
Foreign.
Because when you go to some office, when you lost your job, when you, even though you are here 8, 10, they will tell you, this is Stranat. You know, in everywhere you go on your OIP or your this is Stranat. When you go to this office, I want to do this is Stranat. When you earthquake happen, it's make your house breaking, you don't have where to, this is Stranat. You cannot get house like a Croatian. You cannot get help of the government in some side. You cannot get bank money to support your business because you are a foreigner.
Yeah.
A lot of things, the system make you foreigner. And even though you think, oh, I'm a Croatian, I went home crying like, how I spent my whole 8, 9, 10 years and someone would still tell you, Prosti, this is Stranat. It's
But, ali to je okej, okay. Nema veze. Neko ne kaže nama da smo mi stranci, mi nismo stranci. You know, ti to znaš u sebi da nisi stranac.
I could have gone far.
I understand
far.
Him. Yeah. Situations you feel like, okay, you didn't have to tell
I could
me.
Have. Now, will I feel Croatian, even though I got my citizenship and everything? I've been paying my tax from the beginning until now. But I think it's just in our head and things will get better, you know, having family here, having child and everything. It's very hard question that we don't know the answer. Maybe we, you know, I don't know. Can you really be a Croatian? That's the...
Yeah, we can be Croatian. Like, we don't need to approve nobody for us to be Croatian. You can be whatever you want.
It's a very sad question and I know a lot of things,
but yeah,
this is Stranat, of course.
Well, in that case, I have a question. What do you guys tell you people back at home about your lives here?
Oh, we are like living here in
the golden state of the,
really?
Of the planet. We are working
I
a lot.
I tell them the truth.
okay, it depends, like...
Whom are you talking to?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ako pričamo recimo
a
sa
familija.
Je. Baš tako. Ako pričam sa obiteljima, oni možda znaju više o tebe da, zato što svaki dan u kontaktu, pa znaš čim se baviš, šta radiš. Ako pričamo od očekivanja od njihova. If we are talking about what they are waiting from us, like
the people to work, who like you're in Europe.
Da, i sad ti radiš tu i zaradiš i ali okej, to opet ima veze sa našom odgojem, jel neki ljudi su odgojeni tako da možda oni nikad ne kaže tebe da ti nama trebaš pomoć, ali tako si ti vidio stricovi, bratiće, ovo, ono, pa onda i ti želiš tako.
Da.
Ali općenito, znaju, ja nisam menio, ja mislim da sam isti i kad idem doma, znaju ljudi čime se bave, znaju, uvijek je pitanje da li si i dalje bavi sa glazbom, kako sviram bubanj, da, i tu je, ili oni to i vide sad, on social media, oni to može sve pratiti šta ti radi, šta ne. Ali imao jedan, samo kratki primjer, jedno vrijeme sam radio u jednu udrugu gdje sam bio radio u kaznionicu, u Glinu i ono, odgoj muškarca, rodno ravnopravnost, tema i to. I kad sam prvi put išao kod moje roditelji doma nakon posla u papu, kad smo imali godišnji, tada su moji preselili u jedno naselje, nije naselje, ali da, grad blizu mog gdje smo rođen. I tamo živaju svi ti Romi i miješana ekipa Škalije i to, Egipćani, whatever. To je jako komplicirano i to tome nećemo pričati, ne da mi se. Jel tu onda ne pripadam niti Aškalija, ni Rom, ni ništa. Bolje pripadam Hrvat. Ako ne prihvataju, nema veze, ja sebe, mi je lakše tako.
Da.
I uglavnom tamo sam išao prvi put i vidio sam ove male Aškalije i Rome koji su došli pitati čime se ti baviš. I kad si ti onda počeo pričati njima da ti radiš, ne znam, u zatvor i radiš, i onda njima to je bio to tako, wow, zatvor, može nam pričati više. I odjednom počeo sam sa dva ljudi pričati. I onda na kraju taj kafić je bio puno ljudi i ja sam morao tamo raditi jednu radionicu da im pokažem kako ja to radim. Jer nisu mogli shvatiti, oni su mislili da sam ja doktor ili psiholog ili nešto. Ja sam rekao, ne, ona što posao je više kao on, integracija, onda, a dobra, kako, šta, onda, okej, ajmo mi sjest tu, daj mi jedan papir, daj mi ovo i počeo sam raditi jednu radionicu. I tu kao malo sam preispituju njih za njihove stave, jer znam da imaju čvrsti stavovi, posebno to ono, muškarac je to, muškarac je glava kuće, to. Ja sam pokušavao njima nekako obolažavati da možemo biti muškarac to ko će raditi, to je sve u redu, ali muškarac ima i druge obaveze ko treba ono, pomoć svojoj ženi, pa kad si zadnji put, baš je pitan, kad si zadnji put uspavali dijete, samo vidiš odjednom niko ništa ne priča. Kada je to bio? Pa ne znam. Pa
pitaj mi.
Evo, ovo posao rade, ne? Točno to, da. Tako da, to je to. Mislim, ima to puno za pričati, ali ne bi možda trebamo previše ići na tim puno nekih detalja.
So how can misunderstandings cause frustrations in your daily life? Do they cause frustrations at one point?
Šta to znači? Ne razumem.
Na primjer, when I was thinking my husband is abusing me, calling me an animal, and I was so frustrated and I didn't know how to tell him, and I kept it inside myself for 1 month, and now it's a laughing story the rest of our lives.
Well, with me, that mukuya. With me, when I understand that, I think I am the trouble because I didn't understand much what my partner is talking every time about something, so I try not to get angry. But sometimes I might be really, really angry. Please don't be angry on me for not, this is not my language. I'm trying to, you know, get involved. But I just, sometimes it can be very, very upsetting.
Yeah.
But when you wanted to have a life, you have to, my woman, she's my boss. So I kept it cool because I like to keep learning. So I'm learning and I will not get angry because of this. But sometimes when it's really like too much, I go somewhere, I cry. Believe me, men don't cry in Africa. I do, in a corner, just to let it out.
Do you guys think humor can be a tool for solving misunderstandings and unpleasant situations?
Da, definitivno. To najčešće imam takve primjere, recimo, kad se upoznaš sa nekom ko ono, prvi put, ko to zna biti svaki dan, ali uvijek upoznaš nekoga, I ne znam, ono, prezentira se, ja sam, ne znam, ta i da, i onda odmah pitanje.
Pre što on dođe pitat, ali zašto, recimo, ti sa Kosovo, ali nisu sve
u Kosovu ono, crni, onda ja tu odmah krenem, da, ja sam cigan, cigan, ono, gypsy. I onda sa tu...
I say that also, to make it better for both of us. Yeah, I also say, ja sam ciganka, leave me alone.
Da.
You know, a lot of Romi, when they see me, they call me brate.
Brate, like, disi, da.
They say, like, really, really brate. Ti, ja.
Mi smo original, brate.
Mi gledamo isti. Mi ovde... So it's good to be really human. Like what I told you, what happened in coffee shop or something. At the beginning, it was really, really crazy. Like, but when they understand that I'm, you know, learning and
Croatia,
you know, it, we all laugh about it. When you laugh about it, you know the right words. You just have to say it. You just have to be, you know, it's better to make, you know, to be friendly, you know, to laugh, to talk, even though it's about him than to fight, to become aggressive.
Ne, fight to nije nikako, ne. Ali lepo je to raditi ono tom šalu, ono kao to da, become, ja sam ne znam.
Yeah, ono, it's, I think humor, it can make you learn a lot about language. You know, it can bring you new friends.
Mm-hmm.
It's the best thing. Than to
it
get
can make
aggressive.
An awkward situation
yeah,
easy
awkward
to
be easy, and you learn to through this. You now change.
So that means we all use humor sometimes in unpleasant and misunderstanding situations.
Yeah, should.
But can you suggest humor as a strategy to go around these situations? I think for me I would, but it also depends with the situation or the people, the crowd.
Ja mislim da bi treba to, recimo, ako vidiš u društvu u kojem se okružuje i vidiš da celo vrijeme potencira se nešto u kojem se oni zapravo ne osjećaju dobro, zato što, ne znam, nisu se navikli imati u društvu, ne znam, dva lika iz Afrike, jedan iz, ne znam, ono, Italije. Ok, možda ovo ko su malo više, kad pričam sad, moram malo povezati to malo, kad pričam taj rasizam i humor, to ono, ljudi koji u društvu imaju friendovi koji što, recimo, ne znam, evo, princ je uključen sa nekom društvom gdje su Hrvati sve, pa princ nije, zato što je iz Afrike, odmah tu i priča je drugačija, ono, malo se rezerve priča, ali da bi sad bilo tu upušteno atmosfera, onda lepo bi bio uvijek kao okej, dečki, ajde, ne znači da ja sad ne pričam najbolje hrvatski, da ne znam, ono, ne razumemo se, možemo se šaliti ili bilo šta. Recimo, na primjer, ja uvijek volim kondencirati to da sam cigan, ili kad se priča onda u ciganim ko neku drugu slučajno, daj nemojte biti oko cigane, onda kad vide tebe, onda kaže, joj, proste, nisam isto nešto loše, onda to mene više, ono,
da.
Ne ljutiti u način mene osobno, nego ljudi da li stvarno ljudi, možda vama u tu situaciju kad pričam sad vama, je recimo u bus ili bilo gdje da idete, ima racizam koji je vidljiv, ali ne priči.
Ne priči, to je sistematik.
Sa mnom je to i pričljiv dio svaki dan, jer tu kaže, pa to je u našom kulturu. U našoj kulturi je da kažemo cigan, to nam je ostao, ali zašto, brate, ne želim da ostane. Zašto ne kažeš neki drugo, ali zašto celo vrijeme samo to cigan? Onda tu, to ono...
Nemoj mi zove crnci, nemoj zove Afrikanci. Onda šta oni će mi? Čokolada.
I will cut it short because of time with my little short example. There's a guy, old guy, one time I was waiting for a tram and he just came and started pulling my hair. Al to tvoje frizura, oprosti. And immediately, and I was fighting with myself, što ću radi, should I answer him politely or what? I said, breathe in, out, and immediately I turned and I pulled his hair. And he was like, oh, prosti. I was like,
sve u redu,
super. Unfortunately, we have to go. Yeah, I hope we meet again and catch up some more.
More.
That's it for us today, and I hope you like our talk, and we'll see you in another time. Thank you.
Thank you. Voila. Voila.